Hello, welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. Like cookbooks, there are never enough books about films, film funding, how to make them. Well, the book I have today, each and every chapter could be a book in itself. It's written by my guest, Carole Lee Dean. It's called The Art of Film Funding, and it's published by Michael Wiese. Welcome, Carole.
Thank you very much, Connie, for having me.
Well, my pleasure. And boy, did I, and I thought I knew everything. You know, to read this book is to see a whole other way of going. I mean, I'm not funding a film, but I can only say I will tell people how from having read this book.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, this came about because you at one point were the only person who realized the short ends of movies, big movies, they had shortcuts of film. And I think even that, have you written a book on that experience?
Not really. I've put a few ideas or a few experiences that I lived with on The Art of Manifesting. It's sort of a combination of keeping the positive thought, image, and setting your own goals and achieving the impossible, because that's what I did when I started that film business with $20 and ran it up to almost $10 million in sales. You have to believe you can do it, and that's what I call the right brain information, and the film funding book is the left brain. That's your to-do list. But if you don't have the belief and the faith, then forget the to-do list.
You also have to realize it won't happen overnight. Reading this, it seems to me it would take a good 3 years.
You're absolutely right. I always say, are you sure you want to devote 3 years of your life to this film? And if that's true, then you have to sit down and write out for me and for yourself, what is the purpose? Why are you making this film? That's number one. Number two, where will you find the time? Can you put in 20 hours a week? Because it's going to take that, as well as your family time, you shouldn't give that up, and your job, whatever you have going. An excited person, an excited filmmaker with a lot of passion is great, but that won't last you for the 3 years. It has to be a total commitment.
And you have to know that just because you shot it with a little camcorder and it looked good to you, that's fine for loving hands at home. Now you've got to realize that, well, according to my guest, put it down in writing. Put down in writing what your film is going to be about. Put it down in writing. Who's the market for it? And where will the funding come from? Now, the most important to me from other books that I've read is get anyone who's in that shot to sign a release.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely, because I also work now as a fiscal sponsor for people who are making doc shorts and features. And that is the mandate. You must start from the very beginning and have a release. And one of my filmmakers found someone he wanted in his documentary, and the man was very wealthy, and so he said, well, that's okay. He got so involved in the man's life, he forgot to ask for a release, and now the man wants the rights to the film, and of course he's never had to deal with this before, and he's in a quandary over what to do. It doesn't matter who it is. Rights first, turn the camera on second. Yeah. That's the way it has to be.
And the other is, there's a man whom you talk about who was so excellent, Zachary
Irving.
And sort of run through what you do in the book about the history.
Well, I started a grant in honor of my father, Roy Dean, many years ago. My father loved filmmakers, and when they would come in, Dad was often giving them the raw stock while I was upstairs chasing the money, looking for payment on hot checks and looking for new customers. So when I discovered this after he died, actually, and so I started the nonprofit From the Heart Productions as a way to support filmmakers through a yearly grant. So now we give 3 grants a year. Well, in New York,
may I ask you, how much is involved in the grant?
It runs around $35,000 each. So we give close to $100,000 in the three grants. Most of it is goods and services. It's music from David Rankin, who is a brilliant composer, trailer editing from Bill Woolery, who did the E.T. and Unusual Suspects, and on and on. I have so many fabulous donors in New York. It's DuArt. And in LA, it's Edgewise. They have been with me for years, because this is our 20th year now for the film grant. But one of the first winners was Annie Stern, who just did that great documentary on the comedian. Forgot her name. Joan Rivers. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, Annie won that year, but the runner-up, I really loved his name, was Zachary Irving. And he was a promising filmmaker. And he had an idea for a film about the chain gang, which was alive and well. And I thought the best thing I could do would be to give him the Rostock. So I did. I became his, actually his executive producer for Chain Gang. And he...
Also Angel.
No, thank you.
Yeah.
He did a great job. And from that film, he went on to become a producer for TLC and Discovery and several other places. So I think that our grants, not only making films, they're making filmmakers. Barbara Leibowitz, Annie's mm-hmm. sister, won one of our grants. I was so excited for her. She made her first documentary through us. Now, this is keeping the faith. Barbara had her film crew standing by in case she won, and she got me out of bed at 6:30 to open the office at 7 and give her the film stock. She won about $3,000 in Rostock. And she took that and her cameraman and went out to a prison. She already had the release ready to get her in that day. So this is what it takes to be a filmmaker.
That's Shakespeare in prison?
Well, no, that's another film that won. Mm-hmm. Shakespeare Behind Bars.
Behind Bars, yeah.
That was a good film, too.
Now, there is a future for documentaries today.
Strong future.
Yeah.
I have been saying this for 10 years and people thought I was crazy, but I said, no, watch out, docs are hot. And something has shifted in the consciousness because 20, 15 years ago, if you said, oh, there's a documentary on, they would say, are you kidding? Forget it. But now, what's it about? They're interested. And I think Michael Moore deserves a great deal of mm-hmm. thanks for breaking the ceiling with some of his films and getting some good money for them.
Well, also because he made them entertaining. He knew how to pull the audience in. And one of the most important things for the filmmaker to do is know how to do a log line.
Very important.
All right, what is a log line?
It's a description of the film that is really one or two sentences max. It started years ago in the studios where they had writers on staff, and some brilliant woman was given the task to go into the libraries, take each one of the scripts and write a one or two sentence description of the film, and they called it the log line, and that's how they logged that script so they could find it when they needed or wanted something similar.
Now, the other thing they must know, that person who's making that documentary, you're looking to do get a funding, you're looking to get a grant, read the words in that grant. What are they looking for? And how can you use those words for when you are writing to get the money?
Exactly right. One of my criteria is that I'm looking for films that are unique and make a contribution to society. And I love it because filmmakers hang their hat right on that. They say, my film is unique because, and I'm making a contribution to society, and here it is. And they tell me about it. And I think for any grant you go for, you have to think about the people who are judging your grant. Usually, the judges have piles and piles of things to read at one time. So how do you make yours stand out? And that I have outlined in the book, the areas that you really need to focus on in your proposal. And more importantly, you need to let them know how your film fits their grant.
Yeah.
It's a hard thing to do, to grab their attention, but I will tell you that one time, that filmmakers do unique things, because the most important part of funding your film is to take all that creativity you have for film fund, for actually for making your film, and turn it into the film funding area. So everything you do has your creative mark on it. And I had an Indian film come through my grant, and the woman put ribbons on it. So everywhere I moved that on my desk, the ribbons were flowing, and I couldn't forget her film. It was wonderful.
Fiscal sponsors, nonprofit?
Yes, this is the really the important thing for a filmmaker, and we are fiscal sponsors for docs, shorts, and features. A feature can do this because you're making features now for $200,000 or $300,000, and the idea is that your donors, your people, get an immediate write-off on their taxes if they give the money to a nonprofit. So you can go online and look for information from theheartproductions.com. I've outlined for you, and actually have a YouTube explaining to you what questions to ask when you're looking for a fiscal sponsor. You want to know what the cost is. Do they have a fee to join? Do they have a yearly fee? And what percentage do they take? Because everyone is different. What rights do they want of your film? You don't want to give up any rights at all. And often you may want to start your film as a donation, as a tax-free, and then switch later if somebody comes along with $50,000 to give you and they want ownership. You have to make sure you can do that with your nonprofit. But it's beneficial to you because it's immediate write-off for your investor or your donor.
Which is a big selling point when you are looking to get funds.
Absolutely. Yes. It's the right way to go.
What about putting bits of your film on YouTube or a couple of the other places you mentioned in the book to see, will it attract money?
Absolutely right. You're so smart because first you get the idea. The next you have to say, does this have legs? Where is the market? Who's going to like it before you put your 3 years into it? So I think that if you shoot a little bit of the film, put it on YouTube, or even do a Vimeo, and then send it around to people you know, especially filmmakers, and if you have any distributors or anyone in the industry, what do you think of this concept, and get feedback. And if it's thumbs down, forget it. Wait and find another idea.
Yeah. What are the other places on the internet that you could put a video on and say, send the money if you're interested, support this? I've gotten it from people who said this book, the author needs some money, etc.
Well, there's a new game in town now, crowdfunding. I am a partner with Indiegogo, and the first time I ever heard them talk about what Indiegogo does, I was amazed because she was quoting from my book, the first edition, saying that people give money to people, not to films. And this is the truth, but she had, and the women that started Indiegogo were very smart. They read everything they could get their hands on and then did the outline for you, which is years of knowledge into one outline. And it basically is talking about donors want to know what's in it for me. So Indiegogo created a lovely platform where they host you, and you put your trailer online and you pitch your project, and then people can donate to you, and they can do it with or without a fiscal sponsor. But I will say to you that I have a lot of people come to me and say, I want you to help because my donor